ChatGPT on an iPhone. Let's go. Tell me a sentence where every word starts with the letter A.
Absolutely amazing apples adorner and awesome as your altar.
Awesome. Now how about letter B?
Beneath big brown branches, bluebirds build beautiful nests.
Beautiful. Thank you. Stop. All right, so what just happened here? We had a little miniature conversation with ChatGPT, and it remembered all the conversation history. So let's see what's going on. In our Notes app, we have a log of the whole conversation. So the context, what I said, what it responded, what I said, what it responded. And it's reading from this to get the whole conversation history and then writing to it when you prompt it. So we can go back and edit this or copy from it or whatever. Now let's do a new chat. New chat. What were we just talking about?
I'm sorry. I don't know what you were talking about previously. Could you please give me more context or repeat your question?
Stop. So when we said new chat, it started this new chat history. And, you know, it didn't have that previous conversation in there, so it didn't know what we were just talking about. But we can start however many chats we want to this way. The old one's still there. And so when it's looking for what chat to use as the current one, it uses the most recently modified note. And so if we make a little stupid edit here, like just add a space, then this will be the conversation it remembers. What were we just talking about?
We were talking about sentences where every word starts with a specific letter of the alphabet.
Stop. So this is awesome. You can even use it with Siri. It's a little jankier, but it works pretty good. Hey, GPT.
What's the text?
Do the same thing we were doing before, but with the letter C.
Crimson-colored crabs crawl cautiously, carrying crusty crumbs. What's the text?
Awesome. Thank you. Stop.
Okay, I won't.
All right. And so since this is a shortcut, we can see exactly how it works. So I gave kind of setup instructions here, how to use it. The two key words are stop, which, you know, stops it prompting you for more questions, and new chat, which starts a new chat session. Then they all get saved in the notes folder. All you really need here to get started is an OpenAI API key. You can sign up for this on their website. It's not free, but it's like pennies per question, so it's super useful to play around with. You can choose the model you're using. GPT-4 is kind of slow to respond, but it gives better answers. And you can play around with this. You can change like what voice you're using, how fast it talks to you. And so what I've been doing is, you know, on my drive to work in the morning, I'm just here having conversations with ChatGPT, learning about stuff. And, you know, you can't always trust 100% what it tells you because it can be confidently wrong. But this feels like, you know, the AI assistant of the future. It really feels like you're having a conversation with someone that knows pretty much everything. You know, it's a million times better than Siri. Play around with it and let me know what you think.